Hey, welcome to Mikey's Video Game Madness. Today we're playing Doom, the 2016 version on the PlayStation 4. I'm probably gonna get my ass kicked. Let's continue. A lot of people before this game came out, I read how slow it was gonna be and all this bullshit. This game runs super fast. I don't know what the hell they're talking about. It looks quite nice. It runs at least close to 60 frames for a second. I heard the console version stutter sometimes. I'm not saying it doesn't happen, but I myself have not noticed it. Maybe it's because I'm used to be playing games at 30 frames per second. This game takes a lot of what people didn't like about Doom 3 with its slower survival horror-like pacing and adds a lot of aspects in the older versions of Doom where it's more action oriented. Let me turn up the brightness a little bit if I have that option. I'm using this recording device sometimes. I didn't even know you had a option for all this stuff. Good to know, but I'll leave it alone. Yeah, the colors are a lot more vibrant. Obviously, I made it more vibrant for recording. So, people say there's parkour in this. I would hardly call climbing up a cliff parkour. Sorry, I'm OCD. Well, it looks close to the way it looks when it's not on the recording device or whatever you would like to call it. So this game has like some elements of Doom 3 and then some elements of the original Doom, which is more action-packed. This game is not slow by any means. There's these rune trials. I'll try to do it, but I'm kind of shitty at it, so I don't know how many tries I'll have to do. The loading times are a little bit long, at least on consoles, but nothing that you haven't seen before. They're not obnoxiously long, but there are times where sometimes you want to get into the experience and you have to wait. I do like how this game is separated into levels like the original Doom and Doom 2, I guess. So it's like a hybrid of Doom, the original Doom, Doom 3, and then maybe a pinch of Wolfenstein: A New Order. It's not as complex, although it has leveling up in it and weapon modifications that are kind of intricate for this type of game, but there's no reloading in the game. Even though I've heard some people bitch about the AI, I think it's actually quite good based on the types of enemies you fight. Obviously, I fucked up. Try it again. Otherwise, I might skip it. This isn't part of the main game, this is optional. Basically, you get little perks when you beat these segments. The imps look kind of weird in this game, I will say. But who the hell knows what they're really supposed to look like based on those sprite-based characters that are all chunky. It's kind of hard to tell what anything was. First time I ever played Doom was on the 32X. I died. It's so easy to die in this game. This is one of those games where I will say, like, a mouse and keyboard would probably benefit you more. But I don't mind playing on a console, but this game is fast and will kill you fairly quickly. It's, at least on the difficulty I'm playing, it doesn't feel unfair. When they glow like that, you can do glory kills, but I only have a certain amount of time. But every time you do a glory kill, you get health and stuff. It's hard to be precise sometimes. Most first-person shooters these days cater a little bit to the controller. But a game like this to me feels like it definitely had a mouse and keyboard in mind. There, I got it. I will admit, when I first played this game, it took me off guard, like how fast it was, but it's great. I don't really have another game that plays like this, except like the original Doom. But it has the graphical flair of like a newer game. I'm not going to show you multiplayer, the Snapchat thing. I actually, with Snap Map, I was just called it Snapchat. Snap Map. That seems pretty cool. It almost seems like you would want to write your level down on or draw your level on a piece of paper first before you even start the game. So now we have a rune. I only have one option and one slot, so obviously we'll pick this. Basically, now this upgrade makes items, I guess, get drawn to me a little bit more. But yeah, it has the atmosphere of Doom 3, and there's like horror elements, and it has some story, but not that much. Basically, you'll have an exploration portion, and then all of a sudden, you'll get surrounded by all these demons and stuff, and you gotta fight your way through. And you really should take advantage of the little brutal kills or whatever they coined those kills as. I forgot what Doom called them. They actually had them in Brutal Doom. I think that's where a lot of the complaints are coming from, people that are just so used to playing all the mods and shit like that. I don't like those guys with shields. There's only one weapon that I've played so far that actually has a aiming feature on it. Unlike the original Doom, those fireballs that they shoot at you, they kind of calculate where you're walking. So if you're trying to strafe to the left, they're gonna actually lead you a little bit so you run right into the fireball. This is only like the fourth level. There's no spoilers here or whatever because there's really not that much story to be told, at least from what I've experienced. The imps on here are fucking assholes because they climb on everything and then they run away. They're pretty smart, actually, I'd have to say. At least they're smarter than a lot of other enemies I've experienced in video games. I don't like these guys at all. These are like, I don't even know what they're called. Right now, I'm using the plasma gun, which, if you play Doom, I'm sure you're familiar with. And I'm missing the person. Our demon. I don't think that was ever a person. I know some of the monsters in here used to be people, according to the PDA. By the way, if you want to see the menu, this is what it looks like. Actually, I had 4 points to upgrade, and I didn't even realize it. This is your pistol. It's like the weakest weapon ever. It's more weak than the pistol in the original Doom, but usually, if you look hard enough, you actually can find weapon or ammunition for other weapons. think I can afford any more upgrades. The pistol's like a last resort weapon. The only time it's useful is if you charge it. The levels are really maze-like, like the original Doom, which is a good thing, but and if you look at the top of your map, it kind of leads you where you need to go, but it does get somewhat more maze-like than the originals. Like in the originals, you didn't really jump or do any platforming or anything like that, so you could kind of like feel your way out. Doom 2 had more of the platforming, but every time you did any kind of platforming, you would just run, and your momentum from the running would make you go to the next platform, so it wasn't really that big of a deal. Don't get me wrong, the level design was really good, and I'm curious with Snap Map what people are going to come up with, like, because with games like Little Big Planet, it blew my mind when people came out with the little pieces that they had. Like, somebody actually built a actual functioning freaking calculator, which blew my mind. I don't even know how they did that. I can't even fathom it. A great thing about Doom is you know you're on the right path when you actually have to fight demons. Unfortunately, the sound's down, so I can't hear them if they're around. Somebody said that, yeah, this game has parkour just because you climb on ledges. I would hardly call that parkour. But the weapons feel nice. It does have a very Wolfenstein, the New Order feel to the weapons, except for maybe the pistol. The pistol doesn't feel very powerful at all. I know it's supposed to be the weakest weapon, but it's a little bit ridiculous weak. So obviously that's where I came from, so I'm going the wrong way. I'm always scared to jump in first person shooters on platforming. Platforming on first person shooters has always been sort of difficult for me. This is where I just was. Sorry, I look like an idiot here. I wanted to show you what the game looks like. At least you got to see some shooting. I feel bad about my home front video. There's more story than shooting. That was just the beginning. It's disappointing because the first one had an excellent start, in my opinion anyway. I'm a fan of the first one, so I guess my expectations were a little bit higher. Maybe the game will get better with time, but we'll see. Am I supposed to do something with these pentagrams? I don't even know. It's telling me to go all these different directions, but with the different levels and platforming and stuff like that, it's hard to know exactly what to do, and I don't think I can make that cliff. If I can, it would be a miracle. There's a run button. I definitely don't know how to use it. Is there a run button? I didn't think there was. They call them glory kills, by the way, of the attacks and stuff. But Brutal Doom looks really cool too, so if you don't like this game, you can always play Brutal Doom, but honestly, without copying Brutal Doom and making like a 2D version, I don't know what people were really expecting. This actually went beyond my expectations. This game's pretty awesome just because I suck at it, because I'm still not used to finding my way around this joint. It's an excellent game, and I would highly recommend it if you like these types of games and you have your PDA. This is something that got brought over from Doom 3. You can pause and read all that shit if you want. But I mean, there's information on everything. I don't know if they came out with one yet, but it would make a really cool art book for everything. And I like the enemy designs a lot. Everything feels solid, but this game is unforgiving. This game doesn't hold your hand like most first-person shooters do these days. Which is fine if you're trying to tell a story, but Doom's all about gameplay. It always has been, so they kind of went back to its roots. They did add story elements, and there's elements from Doom 3 on here, but it does feel like an old school game with a fresh coat of paint, and I would definitely recommend it. I'm gonna stop here because I'm not gonna feel the walls, and I think 15 minutes is what people usually do anyway. People usually don't like to watch 40-minute videos, but this game runs really fast. I don't know what it's gonna look like at 30 frames per second, but if you like first-person shooters in the original Doom, my opinion, I would say definitely give this a shot because I think that this is a fantastic game that should be played by anyone who enjoys the genre or the franchise. But anyway, guys, thank you so much and take care. Bye.
If you want to, like, comment, and subscribe! Thanks for watching!